makes you feel so bright and gay. You will be a little joker, and you'll dance it every day.
Ladies and gentlemen, Grandpa Brown, who plays the bass drum, he's just had an attack of lumbago. And since there's no one else in town who can play the bass drum, and you know a band can't march without a bass drum, well, parade called off on account of lumbago. Everybody go home.
I'll do it.
Who said that?
I did.
Oh, it's you, Bumpy Brown. Well, you're only a little fella. It takes a man to play a bass drum.
Well, I'll do it. I've practiced with Grandpa. And everybody stay here. I'll show you.
And so saying, Bumpy jumped on his tricycle and rode like the wind to where the band was waiting. And then...
off his bike jumped Bumpy, up to the leader man. In Spain, in the town of Carambasuvel, lived the bravest matador of them all. His name was Juan Pablo Garcia Miguel. He was 3 feet and 2 inches tall. When night cast a cloak o'er Carambasuvel, Juan Pablo would run to his bed. But he'd never dream of a big ice cream hill. He would dream of the bullfight instead.
Señoras y señores, it is time for the biggest bullfight of the year. Today, we have the biggest bull ever to fight. El Toro Diablo, the devil bull. And fighting him, the only matador in all of Spain who is brave enough to enter the bull ring with Diablo, Juan Pablo Garcia Miguel. And here comes the man. And now for the big fight. Pitting El Toro Diablo, weight 2,452 pounds, 6 feet 8 inches tall, if you do not count his horns, which are 3 feet long, and the brave matador Juan Pablo Garcia Miguel, weighing 53 pounds, 3 feet 2 inches tall, if you do not count the hat, which is 4 inches high. The fight will commence after the march of the Toreador. Señoras y señores, it is time to start the big fight. Here comes El Toro Diablo. And now, here comes Juan Pablo, carrying only a red cloak and his wooden sword.
Poor Juan Pablo, at bullfighting he must be good. For there he is alone with the great big bull, and his sword is made of wood.
And now, El Toro rushes Juan Pablo. Ah, what form, what grace! Juan Pablo steps aside as El Toro rushes by. Uh-oh, here he comes again. Caramba! Juan Pablo stood his ground, and the bull barely missed him. What bravery, what skill! And here comes the bull again. El Toro seems to be tiring. Here he comes. And boys and girls, Juan Pablo has ignored his sword and thrown the bull to the ground with his bare hands. And El Toro Diablo, the biggest bull ever to enter the bull ring, is just lying there. He is afraid to get up. And now, Juan Pablo pulls him by his horns and rides the bull around the ring. Hola! Strike up the band!
In Spain, in the town of Carambasuvel, lived the bravest matador of them all. His name was Juan Pablo Garcia Miguel. He was 3 feet and 2 inches tall. When night cast a cloak on Carambasuvel, Juan Pablo would run to his bed. But he'd never dream of a big ice cream hill. He would dream of the bullfight
instead. We are goody little woody soldiers marching down the street. You can hear the pitter, pitter, patter of our marching feet. Woody Woodpecker's our leader and we really love him so. Woody Woodpecker's the cutest little fella that we know. Hip hooray for Woody Woodpecker, the cutest guy we know. Thank you.
goody little woody soldiers marching down the street. You can hear the pitter, pitter, patter of our marching feet. Woody Woodpecker's our leader, and we really love him so. Woody Woodpecker's the cutest little fella that we know. Hip hooray for Woody Woodpecker, the cutest guy we know. You can hear the pitter, pitter, patter of our marching feet. Woody Woodpecker's our leader, and we really love him so. Woody Woodpecker's the cutest little feller that we know. Hip hooray for Woody Woodpecker, oh my, we love him so.
So chilly all the time. The wintry breezes blow, and zero is below, and that's why I'm so chilly all the time. Poor me, I shiver and I shake. Poor me, me, oh my, for goodness sake. I'm chilly with thee, the penguin. If I could be in some nice tropic clime, get sunburned till I roast and feel as warm as toast, I wouldn't be so chilly all the time. And I shake. Poor me, me, oh my, for goodness sake. I'm chilly with thee, the penguin. If I could be in some nice tropic clime, get sunburned till I roast and feel as warm as toast, I wouldn't be so chilly all the time.
Punchy the clown has a big red nose, lavender hair and purple toes. Everywhere the circus goes, everyone screams for Punchy. Punchy the clown has a heart of gold. One look at him and you don't grow old. Laughter and love come from the same mold. Everyone laughs at Punchy. Punchy the clown has a heart of gold. One look at him and you don't grow old. Laughter and love come from the same mold. Everyone laughs at Punchy. No matter how he feels each day, his smile is fresh and bright. He makes your afternoon so gay. You laugh, laugh, laugh into the night. Oh, Punchy the clown, happy as can be, when he's doing tricks for you and for me. Let's give three cheers now. One, two, three, whee! Everyone cheers for Punchy.
Ha ha ha! canteen lies on the floor. Pepito, Chiquito, the whole world's going mad for Pepito, Chiquito, the lad from Trinidad.
Wonder how this little chick could do the job so very quick. With just one punch, he won the bout.
With the bongo punch, he knocked him out. Pepito, Chiquito, the whole world's going mad for Pepito, Chiquito, the lad from Trinidad.
He discovered the bongo punch. He's making pesos by the bunch. The senoritas a wound for real.
Every time he plays, you hear them squeal. Pepito, Chiquito, the whole world's going mad for Pepito, Chiquito, the lad from Trinidad.
Down in the meadow by the big oak tree lived little Peter Rabbit and his brothers three, Flopsy and Mopsy and Cottontail. And this is the story about Flopsy's tail. Mopsy was a good bunny, tan and fair. His ears seemed to stretch from here to there. He gathered carrots by the pail. But this is the story about Flopsy's tail. Cottontail was the oldest of the three, and he was as wise as he could be. And he gathered berries from hill and dale. But this is the story about Flopsy's tail. Peter was a bad bunny, snowy white. He was often
well, you should have heard the rumpus at the rabbit house that day. A rabbit house, you know, is called a hutch. And since Peter Rabbit's family lived in a very small rabbit house, it wasn't really very much of a hutch. In fact, Mrs. Rabbit always used to say,
"Land sakes alive, such a hutch isn't much of a hutch."
Yes, that's what she'd say. A real tongue twister, isn't it? Why don't you try it with me? Ready? Such a hutch isn't much of a hutch. That was fun, wasn't it? But back to our story. When Flopsy came home with a big hole in his trousers and no tail, Mrs. Rabbit immediately called all of her children around her and said,
"Now, children, you scatter in all directions, and make sure you cover all the sections. Just keep on looking and don't you fail till somebody finds poor Flopsy's tail."
And off they went, hippity-hop, flippity-flop. Cottontail went north. Mopsy went east. Peter went south. And poor little Flopsy, without his tail, went west.
He won't.
Peter walked on, and he soon forgot how important it was that Flopsy get his tail back. He stopped to eat carrots from Farmer Wiggins' carrot patch and lettuce from Mother Jones' lettuce garden. And with his stomach full, he lay down under a tree and fell fast asleep, singing his little song.
Oh, I'll lay me down and go to sleep. I'm sure that Flopsy's tail will keep. I'll find it later, that's for sure. But now some sleep I must see. Cure.
And Peter fell fast asleep. And he slept. And he slept. And he slept. And when he woke up...
Gee willikers, what time is it? The stars are out and the moon is shining.
And sure enough, he had slept all through the day and into the night. And now it was too late and too dark to search for Flopsy's tail. And besides, maybe Flopsy, Mopsy, or Cottontail had found it.
Sure. Besides, maybe Flopsy, Mopsy, or Cottontail had found it. I'm gonna go home to the big oak tree, back to Mommy Rabbit and my brother's tree. And if no one else has found Flopsy's tail, I'll tell them I searched over hill and dale.
When Peter arrived at the big oak tree, Mother Rabbit and his three brothers were all fast asleep.
Here I am, I'm home. Here I am, I'm home. Nobody worry, 'cause here I am at home. Mother, don't you weep. Don't disturb your sleep. Nobody worry, 'cause I'm home in a leap.
But nobody was worried because Cyrus Crow had told them how Peter had slept the day away. And Mother Rabbit and Mopsy, Flopsy, and Cottontail were all angry at Peter because no one had found Flopsy's tail. Since no one would talk to him, and since he had slept all day, Peter just sat there trying to think of how he could get back in their good graces. And suddenly it came to him.
Wake up, everybody! Wake up! I found Flopsy's tail! I found it!
Hearing this, all the rabbit family jumped up and crowded around Peter. Where, they all cried. Show it to us! And Peter said,
have never a doubt, turn his pants inside out, and you'll be goggle-eyed, 'cause his tail's on the other side.
And sure enough, when they turned Flopsy's pants inside out, there was his tail on the other side. And Mother Rabbit was so happy that she forgave Peter for having been a bad boy. And she fed him a big dish of blueberries, and the entire rabbit family sat around in not much of a hutch and sang.
Down in the meadow by the big oak tree lived little Peter Rabbit and his